Multilines are objects that can consist of up to 16 parallel lines. The individual lines in a multiline are called elements. Multilines behave similarly to polylines. Several connected multiline segments form a single object. Multilines are created using the MLine command, and they are edited using the MLEDIT command. You can justify multilines to control how multilines are placed. The best real-world application I know for using multilines is when creating street maps. To help me design my map, I'm going to attach an image of a small map as an underlay. To start, I select the Insert ribbon. I select the Attach tool on the reference panel on the ribbon. I switch my files of type selection to image files. I select Map 1 and press Open. I disable the insertion point, scale, and rotation options. This means that I will be accepting all the defaults. The map will insert using a 1:1 scale, it will not be rotated, and it will insert at 0,0. I press OK. I zoom extents by double-clicking on my mouse wheel. I also want to fade the image a little to make it easier for me to see my AutoCAD elements. I select the image. On the ribbon, I adjust the fade value to 58. I want to rotate my UCS so that my X and Y axes align with my map. To rotate my UCS, I select my 3D Tools ribbon. I select the Rotate UCS about the Z axis tool. I select a point aligned with one of the streets. The UCS is now oriented, so it is aligned with the map. Next, I need to scale the image so it is 1:1. I use the Measure tool on the Utilities panel on the Home ribbon. I select Distance and select two endpoints for the road named Asbury. I get a distance. The residential street width is 28 feet. Or 336 inches. I can use AutoCAD's calculator tool to determine how much scale I need. I can even use that tool inside a command. I select the scale tool from the ribbon. I select the image underlay. I select the base point. I'm prompted for the scale factor. I type apostrophe CAL to indicate that I want to use a calculation. I am prompted for an expression. I type 336 divided by the number I got when I measured the street. Now when I remeasure Asbury's street width, I should get a number close to 336. It's time for me to start placing roads. In order to do that, I need to define a multiline style. I want to define two multiline styles, one for the residential areas and one for the busier two-lane road. To define a multiline style, I type ML style. I select the New button. I name my first style Single Lane. Notice that your multiline style cannot have any spaces or strange characters in the name. I press Continue. I need to define the lines used for the style. My first line will be offset 168 inches from the center. I want it to be color white and the line type continuous. I select the Add button to add a center line. I set the offset for the center line to be 0. I set the color to be yellow and the line type to be center 2. I modify the third line to be offset minus 168 inches from the center. I set it to be color white and the line type continuous. I press OK. You see a preview of the new multiline style in the preview window at the bottom of the dialog box. I'm going to define my next multiline style. I select the New button. I name my second multiline style Two-Lane. I press Continue. I select the Add button to add two additional lines. I modify the lines so that the first line is offset 273 inches from the center. I change the color to white and the line type to continuous. My second line is offset 136.5 inches from the center. I set the color to white and the line type to -2. I set the offset for the center line to be 0. I set the color to be yellow and the line type to be center 2. I modify the third line to be offset minus 136.5 inches from the center. I set it to be color white and the line type dash 2. The last line is offset minus 273 inches. The color is set to white and the line type is set to continuous. I press OK. You see a preview of this multiline style. The current ML style is set to standard. I highlight the two-lane multiline style and select Set Current. The dialog box updates to display the two-lane style as the current ML style. I press OK. We're going to look at placing the multilines in the roads layer in the next video.